Earlier, someone was asking about some tools related to Go programming, so I wanted to show a couple that I'm using here. Starting out with Oracle, which is kind of a new thing that I've been playing with a bit. It's something that just sort of magically understands everything and helps you kind of play around with it. So I'm in the CBFS project. As far as Oracle's concerned, it has a scope concept, so I'll only consider things in CBFS, but I'm in a third-party thing that I wrote called Go Broadcast, and I'm kind of looking from there. So inside of Go Broadcast, I find a channel, and I ask Oracle the question, hey, tell me about this channel. And Oracle will tell me where it's allocated. So we'll start kind of like, this is where I am, and then it'll show me it came from here, we send to it here, and we receive from it here. Kind of interesting. I do the same thing on another channel, kind of look around a bit. But then there's one channel in here that's used by everything. So this channel here is what the actual broadcast uses. And it shows me the allocation inside of CBFS, one of them. There's two of them. So CBFS allocates it here and here, and then it has a a means of kind of sending. But I'm going to start looking around a bit more. So launch jobs, tell me what calls this. So give me basically what a stack trace would look like calling this function. So I can kind of pop through that stack trace and see where I'm coming from. And that takes me all the way back to main, where the Go routine that started that starts. Now I can kind of poke around in here and say, if you look in the bottom left, you can see on any given function call what the parameters are. Then I can hop straight to a function with godef. It's kind of like tags, except it actually understands everything. Same kind of stuff, showing me the function kind of definition, hop into function. Here's another channel. So this channel is kind of interesting because, as you can see, there's four senders to it, even though there's one allocation. So it comes from here. My internode task queue is defined here. And then I send this to it, I send this to it, I send this to it. And then eventually we get to the place where we actually process the queue. So this is the one Go routine that processes all of that queue and does the different sort of things based on that queue execution. And, sort of look around in there a bit. Again, I'll just use godef to sort of pop around, say what does this thing. And godef, of course, will pop across multiple packages. So here's the update inside of Couchbase, and it'll take me straight into the Couchbase client update method and then pop back with, the correct key for that. Now I'm actually doing a build of CBGB here and having it dump out the coverage report. And I noticed in this util there's a must encode function that's 71.4% covered. So I open this up and I can ask Go mode to say, show me what that looks like in a coverage overlay. And I can see, well, I never actually considered the case where I don't actually have the ability to encode. So let me write a test for that really quick. So I hop into my test, start writing out my little test here. And all I want to do in this test is have the actual encoding fail. So I'm just going to send it discard because I don't really care if it writes it anywhere. And I'm going to make a Boolean channel as the thing I want to encode. I can't encode that, so this should fail as expected. So I want to declare this in a function that I can recover from. So I'm going to panic here because I just realized kind of on the way of doing this that this thing actually type asserts a response writer. So I should make a response writer. I'm kind of lazy and just sort of want to demonstrate this tool here. So let's verify that it actually panics. You could see Go code popping up a completion on that a second ago. Run this test and I find out pretty quickly, I wrote code that doesn't compile, so take me to the place that didn't compile. I meant to put a colon there. Now build this. I made that function, but I didn't actually defer it. That wasn't very smart. So let's defer that, and then do my build again, and this succeeds. Although that's not actually what I want. I actually wanted to run the encoding inside a closure so I can capture that and then continue to run even if after it panics. But when I update my coverage report, you can see that's all green now. I'll probably check in a different one for the actual stuff that I publish, but that's kind of a quick overview of some of the tools that I've got. Very kind of quick overview.